Hello and welcome back to All Kind of Games. Today we are playing with Jelly Jar Media in Downtown Map, and we will complete the task just by running 9 minutes and avoid jumping. So Jelly Jar Media is ready. So let's run. I'm gonna use Minion Launcher and nothing else. I don't really want any multiplayers to complete this task. So let's run and have some fun. Yesterday is 13th of March, of course it's 2024 year, and we already recorded 2 videos in the new version 981, where we have special mission Lucky Days. Yeah, 10 days, we already know about 2 different stage locations and the items, so hope you watched it and you enjoyed. Today we completed 3 different levels, so tomorrow there will be interesting upcoming ones, and after we will complete entire second stage. In the old version, unfortunately, we completed all the walkthrough videos, so with levels 1098, and now we decided to play in the double objective and avoid missions, and where previously we collected 1 or 2 fruits, now we will try and get always 3, so it will be fun and entertaining, because of often we are combining this task with the double objective missions. We are activating props, minigames, golden tickets, sometimes we are running in the red crosses and the red zones, sometimes we are using the golden tickets to upgrade some minions outfit. For example, last time we did it for the Sea Dog minion in level 1098 and etc. And yes, the daily boss battles will be also recorded. And last time, well, you know, just yesterday or before yesterday, we defeated all 4 bosses with the AFL minion. So we will start recording different runners who never ever before defeated Vector, El Macho, Mienna, or Will and Triloquy. Okay, Minion Moon has been activated, and this is really, really good because of, you know, that on the moon you are unable to jump over the obstacles and you will not get the penalty time. Same will happen for the fluffy unicorns for the Mega Minions. So with this task, all the bonuses and power-ups are appreciated, and our Jelly Jar Minion will have fun by using every single prop, every single bonuses and power-ups, and so on. Okay, that's great. Mega Minion, and now, oh my god, this is so beautiful. Downtown map, it looks really, really awesome. Okay, we're getting closer to the first fruit, and even without 2 or 3 times multiplayer for the second, you know, we have great progress, and we're feeling it quite good, and it looks better than the 2 times multiplayer and other perks, because of, to be honest, these are lower levels. We are in level 700 and something, but in the 1000 levels, they were so hard that we collected only 1 fruit in every single level. Okay, we can get the vacuum, but I think that instead, I should prefer freeze rays or mega minions and other stuff, so I will avoid splitters and the vacuums. Unless I see something more useful. Okay, and you see, this is a freeze ray, and here we go. We are now free to do whatever the Jelly Jar minion wants. We can break through the objects, we can avoid them, but you should not forget that when you jump over the obstacles, you are gonna have the penalty time, and the progress will be on hold. It's gonna be stopped, and you will lose some time. Okay, first fruit received, and second one is just nothing, because of we are running for all 3 fruits to collect. Okay, in the new version, as I said, there are 10 days in the lucky day, but unlike the previous special mission, Minion Racing, you remember we unlocked that. Oh my god, did you see that? We unlocked Racer Minion in it. Unfortunately, we have 0 new suits or outfits in the lucky day, so I hope that at last, even in the festival, there will be something new. At last, the Migration Minion, who is not new runner at all, but he didn't appear in the stage rewards and in the market. So anyways, it's good, because of this way we will have more and more special missions, more items, locations, and more events. Okay, golden shield, this is really, really useful, and very powerful bonus and power up because of this is that minion shield, which is golden one, will not disappear when you break through the object, so it's gonna remain until the time expires, so it's great. This means that if you play smart, if you play wise with even non-recommended runners and bonuses and power-ups, you're gonna still have always the 3 fruits to expand the jelly lab when you reach the testing area. Okay, did you see that? And here we go, there is a rocket, but I'm afraid that, you know, once we're leaving the rocket, we are always, by accident, collecting any other bonuses and power-ups while we're landing on the map, so I hope that it will not be Splitter or the Vacuum because of Fluffy Unicorn's rocket and Mega Minions are better in this case. Okay, excellent. We are about to grab the second fruit. And yes, this is great gift. We have one more golden shield. Yes, I know that I should avoid jumping, but there is no other way. You see, there are so many obstacles and so many objects. So let's get rid of them, and I'm gonna hide in the Mega Minion bonus and power up. Okay, I see that we are getting the second fruit, but I have no idea how many minutes it will take for the third one, so probably I'm gonna think about an evil minion to charge and activate because of there is only one free revive and I don't really want to waste it. It will be useful for the fourth video where we will record the boss battle with some interesting runners. Or 4 more minutes to go and to have all 3 fruits, but it doesn't really matter because of as we already promised, it doesn't really matter how many minutes and how much time it needs. 10 minutes, 15, 20, 30, 40, or even 1 hour. In every future levels and in the every next tasks with double objectives and avoid missions, we will have 3 fruits, watermelons, apples, and etc. So this way, we're gonna run, yes, in the same levels, but instead of 1 fruit and 2 fruits, we will always have 3 of them. So I think that this is good, and many of you, we are happy once we said and announced about it. And yes, don't worry, because of, as always, there will be new versions, there will be boss battles and versus videos and so on and so on. So now I think that it's enough for today, guys. So thanks for watching and have a nice time. See you today later as always on our channel, and unfortunately because of we don't have red crosses and the red zones in the downtown map, I will show you it in the next locations in the Arctic base or in Edwardo's house. Bye bye!